The next presenter is from Reliance, Vikas Deshmukh, Vice President, Technology Center of Excellence from Reliance Industries Limited. He's going to speak on digital twin applications in hydrocarbon processing industry. Vikas, can you please put your webcam on? Yeah, thanks. It's quite visible. Are you able to listen to me? Hello.
Yes, Mr. Raman.
Yeah, that's great. So I think now you can take it forward. You have your next 30 minutes, even slightly more than that is yours. So please take it forward. Thank you, Vikas, for being part of this session. Yeah, please carry on. Can you share your presentation?
Yeah. Mr. Raman, can you see my screen?
Yeah, we are able to see. Please carry on.
Okay, excellent. Yeah. So, very good morning. This is Vikas Deshmukh. I'm coming from Reliance Industries. Today we all talk about digital transformation, digitalization, and incidentally, we have just finished very good session on digital transformation by Siemens. Incidentally, my today's topic is exclusively on these digital twin applications in hydrocarbon processing industry. I will be talking about how this digital twin has become at the center stage today in view of the different objectives hydrocarbon processing industry has set with respect to operation excellence, be it in a safety, be it reliability, and different pain areas which digital twin will be able to fill in the gaps. So I will be making an attempt to in this presentation about on especially what digital twin is all about, why digital twin is relevant today as far as hydrocarbon processing industry is concerned, and how part maybe which area where this particular digital twin applications is relevant, because I know it is a common thread which passes through majority of these industry applications, and it is going to play a major role. So I have to take you through quickly these few mandatory slides of my organization. So this is a disclaimer with regard to this presentation, and I will quickly talk about Reliance Industries Limited. At Reliance, we believe in made in India, made for India, made by Indians. It is a sort of a company, and which is now at the beginning of a new unprecedented wave of wealth creation for India by harnessing the power of new digital technologies to fire its diverse growth engines. So as far as today's focus area, you all know about Jio currently focusing on digital life, Reliance retail, which is more on consumer goods. As far as our hydrocarbon industry is concerned, we are focusing on these oil to chemicals and aspiring to be a global leader in this oil to chemicals business. So this is as far as the latest development is concerned. And in terms of Reliance company's growth, you can see here, last almost 10 to 15 years, this the way company has grown, and in terms of composition of the business, you can see earlier, Reliance used to be 100% energy company. And last 5 years, now we are transitioning from energy industry to digital and retail. That is basically a consumer-based products. And you know this growth, especially last few years, there has been unprecedented growth, almost 111% per annum. That is what the growth in terms of these retail and these consumer goods. So I would also like you quickly brief on these significant recent developments with respect to Jio platforms, wherein Jio platforms raised $20 billion as a part of strategic and financial this from the investors, especially Facebook and Google on the forefront. Recently, we also had a this LOI on strategic investment by Aramco, that is primarily in oil to chemicals. And another area is Reliance and BP. They are partnering together for fuel retail network and aviation stations. So these are the three latest development I thought I would share as a part of this presentation. And regarding this overall performance, right from the first IPO, which Reliance came up, Reliance Industries Limited, which is the flagship company. And you can see since IPO, our growth has been 32% per annum. And last 25 years, it's almost 21% per annum. And if you see last 5 years, overall growth has been 38% per annum. So so this significant increase in scale due to diversification and especially digital and data and consumer space. So another thing is you can see here this outlook for every business, primarily Jio front, then Reliance Retail, which is focused on consumer, and oil to chemicals, where we are aspiring to be now leaders in this space. So now coming back to the topic, I spoke to you about today's topic on digital twin applications, so which I am going to cover today. So what we believe in digitalization at Reliance, and while hydrocarbon, I am coming from manufacturing, so being a manufacturing at the core, and how we are now embarking on a new digital journey to be a digital champion in this new era. And coming to the main topic, so I'll be covering on this, what is digital twin, why digital twin, and a few of the applications. We did some pilot here, so maybe I will be quickly showing what we have been doing. And as a part of digitalization, what is going to be future of work, and what skills predominantly will be required. So that also I will be covering. And secondly, after this digitalization and digital twin, which is going to be a primary focus area, so what would be end state of this hydrocarbon processing industry? So that I will be touching upon. And secondly, the most important part is as a part of this digitalization, which I feel is a future of work, and what changes will be required, because this change management is going to be very, very critical as a part of this digitalization journey. So as far as digitalization is concerned, this is what we believe in. Data is the new oil for fourth industrial revolution. And the foundation of this fourth industrial revolution is connectivity and data. And this, obviously, data is going to be the new natural resource. And we all are at the beginning of an era where data is going to be the new oil. And we also believe as this digitalization is going to change everything, almost everything, whether it is our work processes, the way we are going to work, the way we are going to communicate, and the way we are going to achieve the operational excellence. So that is what digitalization means to us at Reliance. So I mentioned to you just now that I'm coming from manufacturing, and Reliance, you must have seen the total 65% of Reliance business is centered, that is energy, that's fuels, petrochemicals. And there our plants are consistently achieving the top quartile performance in key operational parameters in terms of world scale, or in terms of integration, in terms of sustainability, in terms of profitability. Recently, we completed our J3 product. And gasification plant, and subsequent to completion of these two big initiatives, now we are directing our focus to digital manufacturing for achieving operational excellence in productivity, HSE compliance, reliability, and quality. And in the overall journey at Reliance, we attribute our success to people and skills, and adopting best technologies and processes, and weaving the robust asset designs and best operating practices. That is what we believe in. So as we are embarking on a new digital journey to be a digital champion in this new digital era, so we all are aware this hydrocarbon industry basically asset intensive, and digital large and large data generation on a daily basis. So in most of the cases, industries struggle to manage and get value from this data, so which is the primary objective of this any digitalization initiative. So what we are currently focusing on doing our as is things, setting and focusing on those, and fixing the issues with respect to data, be it a data integrity, whether it is a IT infrastructure related limitations, whether digital breaks in the overall ecosystems, or manual or redundant process steps that we are having a walkthrough with our operation teams. Then wherever the area where we have a high application or vendor dependency, and there is likely to be slow response to change, those areas we are identifying. And the areas where currently as a part of as-is processes, where there are non-intuitive user interfaces, user experiences, that also we are capturing. And secondly, we are want to focus on next generation digital transformation to make further gains. And through via insights and operational agility, that will help us to make real-time decisions. So that is what our fundamental objective, that is to make this digitalization should be able to help us to make real-time decisions. So coming back to the basics, what is digital twin? That is what I mentioned. So digital twin is being talked about right from 2002. The first definition of digital twin, you can see here. I'm not going to read through every line, but it talks about definition in year 2002, which talks about digital information construct. So this is the how it was limited to. But subsequently, in year 2012, you can see it got how it got evolved further by adding some simulation also, which is definitely important part while we are configuring digital twin for any application. So in year 2006 to 2016 rather, so it after these industry 4 and these new manufacturing systems standards evolved, so now the digital twin talks about these forecasting and optimizing the behavior of the production system, which I feel is the most important, and that is what we will be making most value out of the data. So this as per as a part of this digital digitalization journey. So the first question comes, many people ask why this digital twin is required. So the way I look at it, basically, if you see overall industry focus, it's changing from now, it is not only maintaining the business. So it is now from maintaining business to growing business. That is what industries are currently focusing. Then second most important point is the business model. If you see across industries, it's changing to consumption based model. That is nothing but pay as you use. Secondly, in terms of technology, there has been significant change, and you can see across industries there has been increased demand from technology in terms of cloud, artificial intelligence, big data analytics, fast internet to ensure agility. That is what the industry is looking for, and connected and future ready systems in order to leverage technology as tools to complement and enhance human labor. That is what the biggest value digitalization and this digital twin is going to add. Secondly, these technology delivery models are also changing. We are migrating from these old-aged waterfall SDLC model to agile and DevOps model. That is going to help a lot in order to bring in agility and faster implementation as a part of this digitalization journey. Secondly, the most important point which is relevant to hydrocarbon industry is that hydrocarbon industry digitalization index is low. And if you, this is, I'm talking about with reference to Harvard and McKinsey report, which was published in year 2016. So this hydrocarbon oil and gas industry digitalization index is low. So these are all are the drivers which are the main reasons basically we are now seeing digitalization as one of the opportunity in manufacturing. So we just defined this digital twin. Now I am coming to application areas. So I also talked about digital twin in coming days is going to be a main thread, be it starting from design stage of hydrocarbons industry. And where, so first I will talk about design stage, where basically digital data captured during design and engineering that will help in construction, project and commissioning of new facilities. Then after design, when the plants will be moving to operation phase, then operating plants, this digital twin will help to plant operate within the safe limits. Then also help analyze performance metrics and improve quality of future product iterations. Then while the plants are being operated, the maintenance is also one of the important aspect. So this from maintenance perspective, digital twin will basically preemptively understand a defect in equipment through predictive maintenance and implement service countermeasures. So that will be really important for maintenance and reliability teams. And the last one, which is the most important for organization sustainability point of view, that is the competency of the workforce. So organization are doing driving several programs from annual assurance of their, especially from hydrocarbon industry perspective, all these safety critical frontline positions, that's operation and maintenance and HSE positions. So there what is required is a rapid competency assurance in shortest possible time. So this gap, biggest gap, this digital twin is going to help in having a faster competency assurance. So this is one of the important benefit we see from digital twin perspective. So I'm coming to one application area which we conducted a pilot within Reliance, and that is on focusing on competency development. and we did a pilot with immersive training simulator with augmented reality and virtual reality, and that was we continuously operated almost for more than 6 months, and it was demonstrated to almost 300 end users coming from operations, technical services, HSE, reliability and maintenance team. So what we did basically here, we performed some routine and non-routine scenarios, and we built those scenarios as a part of these immersive training simulators. And with the individuals, you can see this, we trained four young engineers. So we call them millennials. We asked them to perform different tasks and also do some active communication as what is happens in the real world of operations. So that was really important for these young engineers to achieve competency or in a quicker and faster way. So that was the most important aspect of this digital twin. And we received excellent feedback from this young team. And this we feel is a very important from agile mindset of lifelong learning, which is the biggest value addition from digital twin. So another example, we are doing some pilots on overall performance monitoring of the plants. Our plants are running almost 24/7. And from this digital twin, always starts with simple data analytics, whether it is be it a process abnormality or whether it is a equipment failure related prediction. So we also have initial during design stage, engineering stage, we have a steady state simulation model. And based on that, we also build our hybrid models, hybrid data models, which help in filling the overall gap and achieve our final goal of model-based value-added performance monitoring. So this is what we look at digital twin will add, which will have a less human factor and model-based value-added performance monitoring. And that will help us to take into new digital era for our manufacturing operations and technology teams. So from the overall perspective, from manufacturing or overall business perspective, we just talked about, so these are the benefits I see. So whether it is a HSE regulatory compliance, I also mentioned to you about this digital twin helps me to operate plant within the safe limits of my equipments or assets of the plants that ensures me to achieve the productivity and quality. And secondly, this predictive and this aspect of this equipment and maintenance, this helps me to overall maintain my OPEX and overall cost reduction as far as my operation of the plants are concerned. And in totality, this energy management, because digital twin helps in maintaining different performance indicators. We talked about performance monitoring in the previous slide. So the helps plant in a most efficient way. So that is what the primary requirement from a manufacturing perspective in this competitive world. And that is how this digital twin is going to help. So I also initially talked about as a part of agenda, this digitalization and this digital twin that is going to change the future of work and the skills requirement. We also started training our technology operation teams on data analytics and data visualization, how they should be using these new tools, virtual reality, augmented reality. I also gave some glimpse of this augmented reality as a part of competency development. Simulation, we already have steady state operator training simulators. Then cognitive computing, when we are moving from normal data analytics, whether regression, principal component analytics, to the next level of data analytics that we are talking about today is artificial intelligence and machine learning. So there's models, whatever we will be deploying. So there's those models become self-learning model, and they themselves optimize and remove bad actors from the overall process. And we are also now making our new generation ready for these new age devices, handheld, Oculus, and like that. Because we all know this in future, any type of job is going to have a digital component in it. So that is the most important thing. So we are trying to make our young engineers future ready, digital ready, to take advantage of this digital transformation. So overall perspective, this is what digital twin or digital transformation, we see how this digital twin end state would look like. So the final, after this digital transformation, we see that we'll be able to plan our for our manufacturing well. We will be able to operate our plant safely. We will be able to do a monitoring effectively, and finally we'll be able to improve our performance day by day using this digital twin and achieve operational excellence overall. And this is what the governance overall governance model, this digital twin is going to help us in governing our entire processes across manufacturing and entire business. So in short, digital is going to be ubiquitous. That is what I see, and that is what the message I would like to give here. And I also talked about this change management as a part of this digital transformation journey. What is important is at organization level as well as individual level, what is important, this change management is change in mindset, change in organization setup and overall operating model, change in RACI. RACI, I think most of us aware, this is a responsibility, accountability, then consulting and information, that is the responsibility matrix we normally call it. So this is going to have an impact on this digital transformation, digital twin, then team composition and leadership. And finally, on HR understanding and functions, that is the change we will be seeing as a part of this digital transformation. And I remember this sentence by this Charles Darwin here. So it is not the strongest of the species that survives, nor the most intelligent that survive. It is the one that is the most adaptable to change. So this change is the most important thing in digital transformation and this digital twin journey, which is going to be the common thread as far as the entire business is concerned. So that is what all about from my side. And I would like to take any questions from the audience or ARC team, and I'm thankful to ARC team for this opportunity. This is my third appearance in this ARC 2012, 2017, and now 2020. Thanks once again, ARC team, for this opportunity. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vikas. Been an excellent coverage as usual. Thanks for remembering the sequence and the hat trick today. Before you wind up, I just want to ask you one question. You did talk about competency development and performance monitoring of digital twins. How is the experience of Reliance? I mean, how much you could implement, and what is the way forward? Because I've seen people talking about the performance monitoring of the equipment. I was surprised to listen from you competency development digital twin. So that was quite interesting.
Right. Definitely performance monitoring is at the core. And in fact, as far as digital twin is concerned, we started with competency development because from the organization point of view, we believe competency is the most important thing in order to ensure that we operate our assets in a safe and reliable way. So that is with that focus in mind, we started this augmented reality, virtual reality, digital twin. And I also made a mention about this pilot. What we did was a really successful one. And this was demonstrated to almost 300 end users from different disciplines. And this was really successful. And what is important is that the millennials, especially young engineers, they captured and they were on the forefront who were driving this. That was the most important aspect during this implementation.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. We will let you go.